This video will teach you how to break down a DC-20 rebar cutter by BN Products USA. Step 1. Remove the two Phillips head screws to release the fin from the back of the unit and gently pry free. Step 2. Remove the brush caps with a flathead screwdriver. Then, simply remove the spring-loaded brushes. Step 3. Remove the motor housing. Start by completely removing the front two bolts, then just back off the rear two so the handle is loose. Step 4. Now remove the four bolts that secure the motor housing to the pump case, and make sure that you have something to catch the oil as the unit will begin to discharge. Step 5. To release the motor housing, grab the handle and with a flathead screwdriver, pry it from the pump case. Be cautious not to damage the fan, and then the unit should just slide off. Step 6. Inspect the armature for damage and make sure there are no large gaps. And also, check the plastic fan for cracks. Step 7 is separating the pump case from the cylinder. It's very helpful to have this ram set ring for this procedure. You can purchase this tool from us and the part number is 1C0232. This will work for the DC-20WH and the XH. We also have other size ram set rings for other tools we sell. With the proper ram set ring at the ready, take a metal hammer and tap on the oil bolt. Continue to do so until you see the black pump head seals. This is as far as you want to go, just enough to be able to insert your ram set ring. The unit is spring-loaded, so be sure to keep pressure on the pump case as you rotate the first half of the ram set ring. Slip the other half in and secure with the supplied bolt clamps. Make sure the clamps are tight, and then you can simply release the pump from the unit. Step 8. Remove the armature from the pump case by using a rubber or plastic mallet. Inspect the camshaft for damage. Sometimes a needle bearing inside the cylinder will break, causing damage to the cam. This one has just a little scratch, so that's okay. Step 9 is the first phase in separating the cylinder from the front housing. This is an airbag at the front of the unit. It's crucial that this area stay clear of debris. Often, mortar or dirt will get into this area. If not kept clean, it could cause damage to the unit. Now, remove the cutting blocks and always replace if they are cracked or heavily worn. This one is in fairly good condition. This one is also in good condition. By the way, there are 8 cutting sides to the cutting blocks. If they get worn, simply rotate and/or flip. Step 10, begin removing all of the bolts from the front housing. Your air or power tool may not have enough torque, so you can use a 6mm Allen wrench with a cheater bar for extra leverage. Once the bolts are loose, you can use a power driver to finish removing. Remove all of the bolts except for this last one, and make sure that the piston is in good condition. You can even polish it up to make sure there are no burrs or hang-ups when the piston retracts. When removing the final bolt, be sure to put your hand on the back of the unit so it doesn't drop to the floor as it's spring-loaded. Step 11. When the final bolt is removed, slowly separate the two pieces. Be advised that sometimes the piston will stay inside the housing. Just be cautious that it doesn't fall to the floor. When removing the piston, be sure to take it out straight so that it does not jam up and cause problems. So this is the piston with the return valve and two springs. And this is the key and the seal. Be sure to closely inspect the piston for any hairline fractures. This one happens to be in perfect condition. It's now time to inspect this cylinder for any damage, and it's worth noting that if the correct hydraulic oil has not been used, it can break down the seal, and over time, it will disintegrate, causing metal to rub on metal. Step 12 is the disassembly of the cylinder. First, start by removing the snap ring and washer, the needle bearing, and then the ram set ring. Now remove the three rams, springs, and delivery valves. And by the way, all of these parts come with our rebuild kit. After you've removed the components out of the cylinder, you'll want to inspect the bearing. If it doesn't want to easily pop out and is free spinning, we recommend leaving it alone. Step 13, remove the gasket and replace the stopper bolt if it looks worn. Next, you'll want to remove the airbag. Start by taking a large Phillips head screwdriver and give it a tap to release any debris that may have gotten into the grooves. Loosen, and then take a pair of needle nose pliers and pull out the bag from the unit. This is what a worn and a new airbag look like. Step 14, remove the inner seal. As you can see, this one has been leaking for some time. Just take a flathead screwdriver and from the rear of the unit, gently tap to get underneath the seal. Then lift up and remove. Finally, pivot the unit and allow any remaining oil to drain. That concludes the disassembly of the DC-20WH or XH rebar cutter from BN Products USA. For more information, visit bnproducts.com.